This is John Cola with ThrownYourGreens.com. Today we're here in Las Vegas, the beginning of August at the Spring Preserve here on Valley View and Meadows. We're going to check out what's growing in their vegetable garden and see how things are doing since the last time we were here. We're going to check out what's growing here at the Spring Preserve in August after they've had, you know, many days, over a month of over 100 degree weather. What can endure and what will not make it here in the heat in their vegetable gardens at the Spring Preserve. So let's come inside and check it out. So we're here at the Spring Preserve in their raised bed edible vegetable garden area. And you know, once again, the theme of this trip is to see what's still alive here in August in Las Vegas. You know, they are fighting the extreme desert conditions. It's been over 100 degrees for 40 days or some crazy number. I think it only below 100 in like June was the last time it was below 100. So they've been fighting 100 plus degree days. And what we could learn from this is plant things that are climatized that'll do good in your climate. You know, so for example, I don't know, Las Vegas is kind of like Africa, where it's hot and dry, and things grown in Africa would probably do well here. So let's take a look and see what's doing fairly well here in Las Vegas at the Spring Preserve in their vegetable garden area. All right, it's no surprise. Here's an okra. Looks like it's doing very well. One okra plant actually into three stalks, and looks like it's doing pretty good. This is a okra N and S hybrid. I'm not sure what variety that is. Over here, of course, we have the eggplants. Eggplants do really well in this weather. See if we could find any ripe ones there. Oh yeah, there's a white eggplant, little small one. Oh yeah, here, look, here's a little orange eggplant. All different kinds of eggplants. Of course, the grapes, as we saw in Ronnie and Min's show, at Ronnie and Min's place, the grapes are doing fabulous out here in Las Vegas. Almost ready to be harvested, actually. Peppers, looks like there's a bunch of peppers here, and they're ripening up. Look like they're struggling a little bit, but looks like they're doing all right. Of course, more eggplant over here. Different varieties of eggplant. There's a cool one there. Here's a purple variety here. All right, looks like the cucumbers are growing. There's one right there. These look like they're Armenian cucumbers. They get really large. They can get as big as melons, but you can still eat them as a cucumber. They get a bit more fibrous when they get larger. So what I like to do is actually juice them. They make a delicious cucumber juice. Let's go into this other area where they have a lot of tomatoes growing. And the tomatoes aren't faring so well here with this high heat, high degree weather. And they probably didn't plant the right varieties. This looks like be a common red cherry tomato. Oh yeah, look at those figs dried on the tree. Look pretty ripe there. Let's see, some other tomatoes over here. It looks like they're drying up, not doing so well. There's a lot of ripe ones, but you know, the plants are definitely stressed out. Here's a couple more beds. You can see we got a couple of empty beds. That's because probably what was in there wasn't doing so well. Here's a artichoke that just fried in the heat. Pepper along with tomato and sunflowers. They're doing really well here. They love this weather. What else is growing here? The Spring Preserve. All right, this is a lemon cucumber bush. There's one little lemon cucumber. I love lemon cucumbers. They're so delicious. Looks like it's struggling to stay alive. We got some more squash here. Looks like the squash is doing real well. The pole beans growing up the wire trellis, looks like they're pretty much dried out, not doing so good. But yeah, all the squash once again. And looks like the basil's doing fairly well. The cucumbers kind of hanging in there, but other things just aren't quite making it. So as you saw, the vegetable garden didn't fare so well, but what I'd like to say is for everybody to learn from these experiences and what's missing in the garden and grow things next year that do really well. So the eggplants, the okra, the watermelons, the squashes. Hey, guess what? Where are all those things from? Africa. It has a similar climate to Las Vegas. So you want to try to grow things in a similar climate. For example, in the Mediterranean, the weather in California, Northern California, is like the Mediterranean. So we could grow things from the Mediterranean region, and that grows fairly well. So like, once again, in the desert, we wanna grow things that would normally grow in the desert. One of the things I don't see here in the desert are date palms. Date palms grow really well in the desert, and you know, there should be orchards of date palms. And actually, about an hour or so away from Vegas, there is a date farm that I wanna get out to pretty soon and visit and see how they're growing dates, one of my favorite fruits in the desert. But next up, let's take a look at another really unutilized tree that grows in the desert.
So here's one of my favorite desert trees that's a hidden jewel in the desert. The Native Americans know what this tree is because they would harvest these seeds and do exactly what I'm gonna do with them. And what this is called, and I had this on my previous episodes, is the Maverick Honey Mesquite. Here it is, Maverick Honey Mesquite. So what we're gonna do today is we're gonna pick up these pods that are on the ground, and these are the pods that are ripe when they've fallen off the tree. You wanna pick them up and carefully look at the pod for any bug holes. And if there's bug holes, we don't want them. We're gonna throw them back. This one looks pretty good. When we're gonna get a collection of these, and you can see there's my collection of mesquite pods. And how you use these and how the Native Americans use these is that they would take a mortar and pestle and really grind these up. So, I mean, I guess I could get a mortar and pestle. Actually, I have one. But if I don't want to work that hard, I'm going to just put them in my high power blender and see if I could grind these up. These are very hard and they may damage your blender. So I don't recommend doing this at home if you want to, you know, maintain your blender. They usually use some industrial, basically, grinders to grind this up, and then you could buy mesquite meal. And mesquite meal is really rich in protein, really sweet, although it doesn't hardly have any sugar. It's really good stuff. And you know, now I'm harvesting my own fresh mesquite to make my own mesquite meal. Oh, and here's an example of one with holes in it. You could see little holes. We don't want the ones with holes because those will have bugs in them, and we don't want any bug parts in our mesquite meal. I always love learning and growing wherever I go and wherever I'm looking at plants. And here's just another example of something real cool you could do at home. So basically they just took some stainless steel wire like I did in my front raised bed, and they used some of these ties and clips to clip them together with a couple eye hooks on the ends, and they basically made a string trellis out of stainless steel wire. So I want to do this to show you guys that you could easily make a trellis out of, you know, a frame, wooden or metal, and then use some eye hooks and some stainless steel wire with some connectors and whatnot. Comes out real nice, really solid, and strong enough for the plants. And plus, I want to remember this one so I could do it one day too. Here's another one of my favorite desert fruits. These are cactus pears. They are so delicious. They just grow on the cactus plant. Mexicans call it nopales. You could eat the pads, but you gotta watch out for the spikes. These fruits look about ripe now, but be very careful. They got spikes, they'll get you, and you don't wanna eat the skin or the spiky area. I got really sick one time on eating it, so you wanna cut it in half and then scoop out the inside and don't eat the skin or the spikes on the outside. Has lots of seeds, and I like to blend those up, just the inside seeds with the pulp in the blender, and then put it through a nut milk bag. Oh, and oh man, that stuff's oh so good. Cactus pears, also called tunas.
So that'll do it for this episode at the Spring Preserve in Las Vegas, Nevada. The Spring Preserve is basically a living museum and garden, open almost every day. You could come and check out if you're living or visiting Las Vegas. It's a great place. They even have educational classes. Actually this morning, they had a class on square foot gardening. Hopefully they taught, you know, climate correct plants to plant here in Las Vegas in this desert heat. But you know what, we're getting out of summer. We're gonna start fall and winter time, and this is probably the best time to grow food here in the Las Vegas Valley. So this is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time, and keep on growing.